Now let's see how a nighttime render works. To have a nighttime render, first we need to set some lightings, artificial lightings. So how about we go to the architecture tab and we can use place a component. We can go to load family, metric, lighting, architectural, external. We have very different things here. How about I go with this one? Okay, I want to open it. And as soon as it opens, you can put it in the project. I'm gonna keep adding more lights, align this path. Notice that you can change the voltage here. Also, when you move along the landscape, it already knows how to fix the elevation and the landscape, so it's going to automatically adjust to the level. Now that we are adding some objects, let's make sure that you know how you can add more components. How about I go to site component, load family. This time I want to add some male figures. I want to go to the entourage folder and bring one of the male figures. I have already female figures inside. Okay, you can add some human beings there. Notice that some of them are sitting, so make sure you're not putting the sitting ones here. Okay. Also, it's a good idea that when you're having a nighttime render, you can add some lights inside the space, and it's going to make the render really beautiful. Okay, so I'm going to go back to Architecture tab, Component, place a component. Load family again. I'm gonna go to lighting folder. This time I'm gonna use internal. There are very different options here. I'm gonna just show you how it works. So I don't know, maybe something like this. Open. You can change the watt and voltage here. You can go with a higher one. I can put it here, or maybe it's a good idea if I go to level 1 and locate the lamps here. I need to select it again and place a component. That's the one. I can put a couple in here. And I can know that I can see these lamps if I look from that view. Okay, let's see. Exterior view, we have some lamps over there. You can keep adding. Maybe I can add some behind that wall on that level. That is level 5. Yeah, maybe I could do that, level 5. How about I go to the component and then add a couple lights here. Actually, I should move it a little bit inside. Okay. I just want to have a good nighttime render. If you already know what's the location of every lamp, not a bad idea to be more precise. Okay, better. Let's get back to the view. So now we have a lot of lights inside and outside. I don't have enough plants. Let's get back to the component, place a component, a load family. Also, let me tell you a trick. If you have both metric and generic or US and Canada, Sometimes US folders have some options that the other one do not. For instance, if I go to US metric under entourage, I do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 car, right? If I go to US Imperial and go to the same folder, you see I also have van and truck here. So sometimes it's not a bad idea to look in different locations. Okay, and as we talked about before, planting has a separate folder. I'm gonna put a couple of them over there, and the whole family of trees are here. Okay, one over there, one a bit closer, and I want to put one over there. Okay, so these are the ones that I can see in the view. And these objects are called RPC object. RPC stands for Rich Photorealistic Content. And it means that they do not take a lot of space, but they are really rich in graphics. So when you are done with lighting and everything, you can go to the rendering dialog box. Make sure to change the lighting to exterior artificial only. This is the easiest way to get a nighttime render. You don't have to change the sun setting or something. You can just, no matter whatever sun setting you have, you can go to exterior artificial only. I'm gonna leave it as the clouds that we have in Revit itself. And I wanna leave them as they are and just see how it's gonna work. So this is the rendered image. You always and always need to adjust exposure when it comes to nighttime renders. Okay, so it goes from something like that to something like this by only one click. Or if you are not satisfied, you can reset it and take care of it again. What I would suggest in this building is that, something like that, okay. We could add some more lights over there and a little bit higher, but it's kind of starting to be okay. I added some more lights to level 7. I'm gonna copy them to clipboard and paste them aligned to selected levels, and I wanna add them to level 8 and 9 as well. Okay, if I go to the 3D view, you can see that I have lamps in all those views. Also, I added some lamps over there. How about I also copy them on the upper level? So it's gonna be something like this. It's not still the best, but it's a little bit better than before. Have in mind that this is on a draft setting. If you put it on high, it's gonna have a better quality. And I wanna just mention that the key to a good nighttime rendering is to have a lot of lighting sources. The more you have, the more beautiful your render is gonna be.